Welcome to the Fox 17 Rock Interview on the web and on YouTube. And I've got the very talented Pete Anderson. You might know him from Dwight Yoakam years that he played with Dwight. But also, he's done incredible producer work with people like Buck Owens, Roy Orbison, Jackson Brown. List goes on and on. I'm tired.
The list is so long. I'm tired.
And you've got signature model guitars that have your name on them at the top of the headstock. Yep. You've been working with Reverend for a while, Pete.
Yes.
And man, you're doing some great work with him. And on the news, we were actually talking about this F-hole model, the Pete Anderson model. And you've done some unique, you know, changes to this guitar.
Yeah, I wanted it to be a working man's guitar. My goal was for a guitar player to go into a store, take this guitar off the rack, sit down, pick it up, and go, you know, if I put my string gauge on the way I want it to feel tension-wise, right, I could play this on my gig tonight.
Oh, yeah.
That quick. And so that was my goal. So the frets that I like are on here, 6105 Jim Dunlop frets. They're a little bit higher.
Yep.
It's got a unique bracing, patented bracing designed by Reverend, where there's a piece of wood, it's like an L shape, so the bridge is pinned in wood. This is all hollow, so there's no feedback. Headstock neck angle is right, so the tension is right. Bigsby, the real Bigsby on here.
And these pickups look great.
Yeah. It comes with P90s. These are Seymour Duncan is a friend of mine for years, and he made these special for me, but it comes with P90s, which are terrific. These are actually humbuckers in a P90 frame with rails instead of pole pieces, so I don't have any issues with string spacing. But this is my go-to guitar. I play it constantly. I play it on tour. On my new record, Birds Above Guitar Land, that came out September 17th, I played it. Played this and this guitar right here, these two actual physical instruments, on 8 of the 10 cuts.
You know, what an incredible CD. We've actually got a photo of it there. And the tracks sound great, Pete.
Thank you.
You know, and so you did most of the work with this guitar then.
Yes, yeah, that's my go-to guy. That's
now, you know, a lot of people know you, and we were talking about how many times you've played The Tonight Show, and a lot of people know you for your slide work, and I know you play the rock slides that,
yes,
that
absolutely,
Danny
absolutely
makes, and you've you use the
revolutionary
the brass and the glass,
yes,
from,
yes,
rock slides, and this is your main slide guitar then that,
yeah,
Reverend,
yeah,
makes.
It's a special, it's I customized it for slide. I mean, they don't make that specific model. It's a one of these. It's a Tele.
Right.
We call it an East Sider because Reverend was on the east side of Detroit, and I grew up on the east side of Detroit.
Perfect.
So when we decided to do a Tele-looking guitar,
yeah,
we said, let's call it the East Sider. That has a short-scale neck that I retrofitted and just kind of like a lap steel gag with,
yeah,
the pickup way near the back. But that's my go-to slide. It's heavy, flat-wound strings.
Gotcha.
And the action is a lot higher.
Well, you know, and I think the East Sider is what I found so interesting was that you added your innovations to that too. I mean,
yes,
you know a lot about the instruments you play.
Yes.
And so you've taken some of the things like on the back of the guitar and shaved this down.
Yeah, it's easier access above the 12th fret. This is shaved down here. It's got a multi-radius fingerboard. My frets, again, 6105s, locking tuners. It's got two tone cavities in the front instead of the back. It's a one-piece body. The body is Carina or Koa, whatever those.
It sounds incredible.
One of those. It's not a maple body. And
right.
It's not ash. And it's just a working guy's guitar, satin finish.
Reverend does great stuff.
Yeah, it's something you just take to the club and start playing, plug it in.
Well, you know,
and
speaking of playing, you've played with so many incredible artists over the years, and your tone is always definable. And I really enjoyed the article in Vintage Guitar that you were in recently, and it was talking about, you know, your new album and everything.
Right.
And so, you know, where can people find, you know, your new album? I know it's on Amazon.
Yeah, well, we the Brain Trust at Pete Anderson got together. And it took us a long time, and I came up with a web page.
Awesome.
And the address is www.peteanderson.com.
You know, I was on there. I was on that web page. You know, and that's also a great place to find out where Pete is touring, which is all across,
yeah,
the world.
Absolutely.
You know, and
yeah,
so that's, and now
and
are
Facebook.
You, now you're on Facebook, too.
Yeah, I used my name, Pete Anderson. I don't want it to be hard to find. There's probably a lot of Pete Andersons on there, but it's the one where I'm the guy holding the guitar. Pete Anderson on Facebook. These guitars are on Facebook, the East Sider's on Facebook, the PA1's on Facebook. But
so are the rock slides.
Yeah, the rock slides, all that stuff is on there. The web page is being updated constantly. There's going to be a lot more educational stuff on
the
webpage.
Well, you know, and I think that's so cool, Pete, that, you know, somebody at your level who's such an incredible, you know, guitarist and producer and everything and doing so much solo work now, you still get back also with the kids.
I love it.
And you're working on tutorial DVDs. You got some new stuff coming out.
Yeah. This year is going to be devoted. The next project will be coming up with a DVD how to play guitar like me now.
Yeah.
I did one a while ago called Roots Rock Workshop.
Right.
And this is going to be the latest, greatest, talking more about complex chords and kind of getting outside of your normal blues licks and playing some other stuff. I've got a couple of concepts that I've come up with, familiar licks in unfamiliar places.
Wow.
One of them.
How neat.
Yeah, so some reharmonization and things like that. But from a perspective, I mean, learning music can be really oppressive, the way it's taught, and
right.
can really turn you off. And I'm trying to make it more easily accessible and easy to understand.
So I think that's great, especially
that'll be
for
the
kids.
Approach. Yeah, and for kids, I love meeting kids. You know, I wish that when I was, you know, 18 or 19, I could have ran into somebody and said, don't bother doing that for 5 years, just do this. So I'm going to be the guy that says, don't bother doing that, do this.
Well, you know, and all of your stuff is going to be on the website.
Yep.
So people will be able to find, you know, your new CD, which sounds incredible.
Thank you.
You're working on a new book. You've got new DVD tutorial.
Yep.
And your tour.
Yes. Yeah, we're playing everywhere. All the time. Everywhere all the time.
So be sure and check it out at PeteAnderson.com, and hopefully Pete will come back on. You can find the Reverends online as well, and a lot of local music stores, great instruments, especially Pete's models.
Yes, thank you.
And thanks for watching the Fox 17 Rockin' Review.
Thanks so much.